So today we are going to see about the unit 5. So unit 5 topic is mechanical properties of materials. So first introduction. So definition of material property. So a material property is a intensity property of some material. So all the materials exhibits many different properties and qualities. The properties of material provide a basic knowledge on for predicting its behavior under various conditions. So that the engineer should have the wide knowledge about the materials and their properties, so that he may select a suitable material for his product. So engineer should have the knowledge about the material properties, then only he can create a optimum products for his engineering process. So the engineer should have the knowledge about the forces acting on the material, so how to affect the material, how to elongate, compressed and break the material, so temperature and other conditions. So the engineer should have all the knowledge about the material. So let's see the different mechanical properties of the materials. So properties of materials, so we can classify this mainly in these categories. So first one is anisotropy, elasticity, plasticity, ductility, malleability, brittleness, hardness, toughness, stiffness, resilience, creep, endurance, strength, impact strength, fatigue. So let's see about these properties. So first one is brittleness. So brittleness is nothing but it is the property of a material by means of it will fracture without any applicable deformation. So there is no elongation takes place in the material, so it will crack itself suddenly when the load is applied. So this type of property of the material is called as brittleness material. So example is cast iron and glass. So this property is disabled is a machine parts which may be subjected to sudden loads. So the engineer should have the knowledge about the brittleness property of the material. So next one is ductility. So ductility is a property of a material by means of which it can be drawn into wires before rupture takes place. So the elongation property is high in ductility materials. So ductility material can be measured by the percentage of elongation and the percentage of reduction of area before rupture. So the material has elongate when the load is applied, then it will take failure, it will take a rupture. So this is the property of ductility materials. So example of ductility materials are gold, platinum and silver. So the knowledge of ductility of material is used for engineering for fabrication operations in product fabrication. So it's mainly used for fabrication operations. So this is example figure of ductility material. So next is malleability. So malleability is nothing but the property of a material of solid materials which indicates that how the material under compressive stress. So when we apply the compressive strength on the material, we can convert the material into thin shapes. So we can use it for different shape. We can convert the materials into different shape based on our product operations. So malleability is the property is based on the plasticity of a material. Malleability material is temperature dependent. So by increasing the temperature, the malleability of the material will be increased. So example of malleability materials are gold and lead. So the material is heated and then it is undergone by the compressive stress. So that can we can increase the property of the material, that is the malleability property. Next is elasticity. So elasticity is the property of a material by virtue of it is able to retain its original shape and size after the removal of load. So this is called as elasticity of a material. So examples of elasticity is steel and rubber. So material can regain its position when the applied load is removed. So that is the property of elasticity. So next is toughness. So it is the property of a material by virtue of which it can be absorb maximum energy before fracture takes place. So it is measured by the hardness of the material. So it is a property of material by means of it absorb maximum energy before fracture take place. So it absorb the energy before it take fracture. So examples of toughness materials are mild steel, brass and wrought iron. Next is fatigue. So fatigue is the property of a material by means of which it deforms under the fluctuation of repeated loads. So the material gone deformed when repeated loads is applied on it. So that is a property of fatigue. So next is creep. So creep is the property of a material by virtue of which it deforms continuously under steady load. So materials that deforms under steady load is called as creep property. So this property is considered in designing IC engines, boilers and turbines. So it is a important property in engineering field. So next is stiffness. So stiffness is a property of a material by virtue of which it resists deformation. So it resists deformation property is called as stiffness. So you can see in the diagram. So when you apply the load, it resists, how much it resists the deformation, that is the measurement of the stiffness. So stiffness is the resistance of the deformation. Next is strength. So strength is the property of a material which opposes the deformation or breakdown of a material in presence of external forces. So strength is the internal ability of the material to resist the deformation when the external load is applied on it. That is the definition of a strength. So this property is used in many fabrication operations. Next is resilience. So resilience is the property of a material by means of which it stores energy and resists shock and impacts. So it resists shock and impacts is property is called as resilience. So it is measured by the amount of energy that can be stored per unit volume after being stressed. So this property is desired for material used for springs. So this property is mainly used for designing and fabrication of springs. So resilience is the property of a material to resist shock and impacts. So this property is mainly used in car shock absorbent system and another systems. Next is technological properties. So we can divide the technological properties into three types. First one is machinability, castability, weldability and formability. So definition of machinability. So machinability is the property of a material which indicates which it can be cut or removed in various machining operations such as tanning, drilling, boring, shaping. So the material should have the property of such operations such as tanning, drilling, boring, shaping. So that only we can use for the fabrication process. So material should have the property of so it should undergone by the tanning drilling operation. So it should not fracture by the tanning drilling and shaping operations. So this is called as machinable properties. Next is castability. So castability is the property of a material which indicates the property of it can be cast into different shapes and size. So by casting operations we heat the material and we apply the compressive stress. Then we can change the shape of the material into another shape. That is the property of castability. So next, third one is weldability. So weldability is the property of material which indicates the ease with. So we know that welding is nothing but the process of joining two materials, so as two similar or two dissimilar materials by heating operation, heating and pressing operation. That is called as welding. So the material should have the property of weldability. And also welding is also used in maintenance works. So if we find any crack in pipes, we can resolve this by the welding operation. Next is formability. So formability is the property of a material So we can convert the one material into another shapes and another size. That is called as formability. So for example, say we if you take the raw material, so we can heat above the recrystallization temperature, then the raw material is converted into a liquid state. So then the liquid state material is poured on the molds. So the different type of molds. So the based on the mold size, we get the different shapes and different size materials. So that is the property of formability. Convert the one material